Hey guys, Mr. Lindbergh here. This is on empirical formulas. If you have what we call a combustion problem, where you have to calculate first the amount of material in either grams or percents. So I'm going to walk you through this first. I'll just read this to you. This technique requires that you burn a sample of an unknown substance in large excess of oxygen gas. The combustion products. Remember the combustion, if you burn carbon, you're going to get CO2. If you burn hydrogen, you're going to get water. If you burn nitrogen, you're going to get NO2. So the big deal, though, is to understand the hydrogen and the carbon. From this, you're going to be able to calculate the empirical formula of the substance because we can be able to figure out the weight of each of the elements. And so we burn them and it's collected. If you want to read more about it, you can look up the combustion analysis and find some things out. Most of the time, it's dealing with carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, but it can include nitrogen and some other elements, could be sulfur, but for the most part, it's carbon and hydrogen, but you use the same steps. So you must know the makeup of the unknown substance in order, when you start, that you can figure out what is it carbon, hydrogens, oxygen. Otherwise, you can always find out the mass of the carbon and the hydrogen. And then you've got to figure out the others by doing some other tests. So you need to know the mass of the substance before it burns. So the mass of the total unknown substance. Number three, carbon dioxide and water are always the products. All carbon winds up in CO2, so if you know how much carbon is in CO2, you can figure that out. Same thing with hydrogen. All the hydrogen came from the And the water came from the burning of the product, burning of the sample. Number four, if oxygen is part of the unknown compound, then it winds up in the oxides. The mass of the oxygen sample will commonly be determined by subtraction. So if you don't calculate it by the oxygen that's in the CO2 or the H2O, because some of it came from air. So you don't know how much of it is, but what you do know is that if you know the beginning mass and it just contains carbon, hydrogens, and oxygen, then you can just subtract. Nitrogen will be determined during a different experiment, but they'll end up telling you then, and or just telling you that this is the amount of nitrogen gas that you end up getting. All right, so that's the layout of the problem. I'm going to go through real quick again exactly how we go about calculating a problem like this. And here we go. So here's the steps, and this should be easier to read. And let me move this way over here so you can see that. Determine the grams of each element present in the compound. So carbon is always in CO2 form, so the ratio is always going to be the carbon over the oxygen. So 12.011 grams over 44.0049. That's the mass of the carbon dioxide, that's the mass of the carbon. So when you end up multiplying your mass of carbon dioxide by the ratio 12.011 over 44.0098, you're always just going to get the mass of just carbon. So it's like we're doing a percent problem where we're trying to calculate what percentage of it is. Well, here's the percentage of carbon and carbon dioxide, this over this, and if we multiply it by the mass they gave us of CO2, we're going to get the mass of carbon. Hydrogen is always in water, and so its always ratio is going to be the same as well, 2.0158 grams over 18.0152 grams. And so there you go. Then you can calculate that out and find out how much hydrogen is in that. Once you get that, we go back to the mass to moles, divide by small, multiply until whole, and that's what we end up doing to get the total thing. So here's rule two, rule three of doing these kind of problems, but they're exactly like the poem. So everything in there, excuse me, scratching my eye, is exactly like the poem. Percent to mass to mole, divide by small, multiply to whole. So let's walk through a problem. If you have 1.5 gram sample of a hydrocarbon, remember it's just made of carbon and hydrogen, it undergoes complete combustion. Determine the grams of carbon and 4.40 grams of carbon dioxide, and the grams of hydrogen and 2.7 grams of water from, these are the products of combusting this unknown hydrocarbon. Well, here's all you do. Remember the ratio we said, you just take the grams of the carbon dioxide that you had, we multiply it by that ratio, and we get the grams of just carbon. We do the same thing for the hydrogen, and we get grams of just hydrogen. Now that we're to grams of carbon and grams of hydrogen, the next thing we do is convert to moles. Mass to moles, divide by small, multiply till whole. So grams divided by the molar mass of carbon, you get 0.099 moles. Hydrogen divided by the mass of hydrogen, and you get 0.2997. Now it's divide by small. So you divide each one by the smallest number. We got 1. This divided by the smallest number, you get 3. We didn't have to even multiply to whole because they're already whole. And so there we go. The answer should be CH3. I know what you're saying, Mr. Lindbergh. That's easy. Yes, it is. So the new step up here, this is it. It's the new step. We're just converting the grams of carbon dioxide just to find out how much carbon is in there. And that's how much carbon was in the compound. So here's a problem, and you can pause it right here. Caffeine is a stimulant found in coffee, tea, and certain soft drinks. Contains CHON, combustion of 1.00, this is in milligrams, of caffeine produces 1.813 milligrams of CO2, 0.4639 milligrams of H2O, and 0.2885 milligrams of N2. So now what I want you to do is write the empirical formula for caffeine, estimate the molar mass of caffeine, which lies between 150 and 200 grams per mole. Remember, that is not going to be the same. The molar mass of caffeine may be the same as the empirical formula mass, but it may be a multiple. So you're going to have to check that out. I'm not going to show you the answer on this. We'll talk about this tomorrow in class, but I want this done, and you're going to show me this so I know that you watched the movie. So we'll see you in class. Talk to you later, because I'm turning it off now.